2019 was a rather busy year, filled with geopolitical events and macroeconomic roller coasters, which caused Brent implied volatility to spike quite a few times. The first big increase in volatility happened during the summer, when bad macroeconomic data, with the IMF revising down its global growth forecast for both the second part of 2019 and 2020, pushed Brent prices down, forcing market participants to buy more put options to limit portfolio risk. The second short-lived volatility spike happened in September, caused by the attack to the Saudi oil facilities. The third one was generated by expectation of OPEC Plus members extending and deepening production cuts. The last spike was caused by the killing of the Iranian General Soleimani in the first days of January. The volatility in the physical market instead dropped from more than 50% in January to 21% in April. But as soon as the summer downtrend started, data Brent prices started to plummet, while the stochastic volatility achieved slightly more than 40% in the month of August. The most notable spike in stochastic volatility happened in September, when the Saudi oil facilities had been attacked. However, the symmetric movement between data Brent prices and stochastic volatility immediately signaled that the violent rise in prices was going to be short-lived. The stochastic volatility dropped constantly from September 2019 until the beginning of January, when the geopolitical tensions between US and Iran pushed it up around 27%. The volatility of the most liquid European petroleum products, like Eurobub gasoline, diesel ARA, or Jet CFA WE, has been literally dwarfed by the unprecedented spike in Rotterdam fuel oil volatility caused by market participants preparing for IMO 2020. The volatility in the fuel market achieved almost 300% in October, and although dropped back, it averaged 123% in the last 2 months of the year. On the other hand, the volatility in all the other petroleum products averaged 25%, with the exception of Eurobub gasoline, where it was around 40%. The aggregated open interest in the Brent options market signals that market participants in January have not changed much of their positions compared to the last quarter of 2019. In fact, the highest levels of open interest are still positioned between the $55 and $70 strikes, indicating that at least for the time being, market participants do not expect major violation of these boundaries. Therefore, the Brent market should not experience implied volatility spikes higher than 45% in the first quarter of 2020. If you are interested in using volatility to leverage and optimize trading and hedging opportunities, please email us at pl_risk@spglobal.com and get the old volatility analytics.